a number of ways to cook scallops, but the chef over at Spread in Portland has the best way to sear them and infuse them with flavor. Here's Jim Keithley with this morning's menu.
We're back at Spread this morning on Commercial Street. They opened last summer to rave reviews. We're back in the kitchen, probably the nicest kitchen in the old port, I must say, with executive chef Chris Long. So what do we got here this morning?
We're going to do a little pan-seared Devo's scallops with a wheat berry, preserved lemon, and shellfish ragu.
Sounds great.
Pretty simple.
What do we do?
Good flavors. I'm going to start on the ragu. Basically, some fennel. Sweat these off. This is wheat berries. So wheat berries are basically the brain, the germ, is all in one. So it's in the wheat. Very similar to barley, if you've ever heard of barley.
Yeah.
They're like beans. You have to soak them overnight. Otherwise, they're very, very hard texture. So then we're going to add the lobster stock. Some preserved lemon. So the Devo's scallops, basically from Harbor.
The secret to a successful pan-seared scallop is what? High heat?
Well, it depends the fish. Basically, with scallops are a different texture, so it's firmer. So you can go a little bit hotter. But with seafood, you want to be delicate with it because you want to treat it nice. So what I work out best for me is right before it starts to smoke, is I'll put them in and then I'll turn it down. And then you just want to let them sit. So you can always check to see if the color, and those look good.
Beautiful.
I have a fennel puree here that we're going to put in the ragu. It's going to substitute, so it's no cream, it's just straight fennel puree, but it kind of gives it that creamy texture, almost like cream and butter. So it's very like the healthy version of it. And then we're going to add all our shellfish in. Like I said, it's equal parts shrimp, mussel, and a little lobster. So all this seafood is probably about 50% already part cooked, and the shrimp is actually raw. So you want to cook them in here, but you don't want to overcook them. Jade fennel and a little citrus vinaigrette, and like I said, you can omit this too, but it kind of gives it a little texture and more for the garnish. It's okay.
Fantastic. Okay. Chef, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Thanks for coming in.
We're going to have the recipe for you on our website, WMTW.com.